Integers are positive and negative counting numbers and the number 0. You can see the list written here in set notation, and you can see them on a number line. Envision them going on and on in the negative direction and on in the positive direction. There is no least or first integer, and there is no greatest or last integer. We're going to discuss adding integers. We're going to use the triple method in order to add integers. This is a diagram of the thought process you should use as you figure out how to add two integers together. If the signs are the same, you're going to use the left-hand side of this chart. If the signs are the same, you will sum the absolute values, and then you will use the same sign as the two numbers that you're adding. If the signs are different, you will use the right-hand side of this chart. If you have different signs, you're going to take the difference, which means subtract the larger absolute value minus the smaller absolute value. The sign will come from the sign of the dominant number, the sign of the larger absolute value number. In our first problem, we are adding negative 4 plus negative 6. The signs are the same, so we will take the sum of the numbers, we will add the numbers. 4 plus 6 is 10. Then we will keep the sign of the numbers, which is negative. So negative 4 plus negative 6, add the numbers and get 10, and keep the sign, which is negative. We can think of this as money as well. We borrowed $4, then we borrowed another $6, therefore we owe $10. Thus, we have negative 10, showing that we owe $10. Negative 7 plus 3. The signs are different, so we're going to take the difference, or subtract the numbers. The larger number minus the smaller number. 7 minus 3 is 4. So we get 4. Then to determine our sign, we look at the biggest absolute value number, which is 7. The number 7 has a negative, so our answer will be negative. If the signs are different, you subtract the numbers and keep the sign of the bigger number. In this problem, we have negative 1 plus 8. The signs are different, so we will subtract the numbers. 8 minus 1 is 7. Then we will keep the sign of the bigger number. The bigger number is 8, and 8 is positive, so our answer is 7. You can think of this as money again. You owe negative $1 to a bank, then you deposit $8. Now your bank account has $7 in it. Subtracting integers. In order to subtract integers, we're going to change any subtraction sign to adding the opposite. So in this case, when we have a minus b, we're going to change it to a plus negative b. And if we have subtracting a negative, a minus negative b, we're going to change it to adding a plus b. Then we will use our rules for adding integers. Here we have 5 minus negative 2. We're going to change the subtraction to addition by adding the opposite. We're going to rewrite that as 5 plus the opposite of negative 2, which is positive 2. Here, the signs are the same, and we're adding, so we add the numbers and keep the sign. 5 plus 2 is 7. 3 minus 10. We will start by changing subtraction to addition. 3 plus negative 10. The signs are different, so we will subtract the numbers. 10 minus 3 is 7. Then we will keep the sign of the larger number. The larger number is 10, and 10 is negative, so our answer is negative. You can think about this as money. You have a bank account that had $3 in it, then you wrote a check for $10. Now your bank account reads you owe $7. So we show that we are in debt with a negative. Negative 6 minus 3. We will change this subtraction to an addition problem. Change the subtraction to adding the opposite. The opposite of 3 is negative 3. We are adding negative 6 plus negative 3. The signs are the same, so we will add the numbers and keep the sign. 6 plus 3 is 9, and the signs are both negative. So we borrowed $6 and we borrow another $3. Therefore, we owe $9.